Grievances be noted, and I call the member for Corangamite.
Thank you very much, Mr. Deputy Speaker, and I'd like to join with the member for Corio in giving him support on the issues he has raised in this grievance debate. The opt-out option for those who are waiting on the transplant list, I think, is a very good initiative. I fully support the efforts to fundraise for the Geelong Peacekeeping Memorial, and I also salute Michael Collins Peirce, who is a real legend in Geelong, but I think more broadly in education in this country. And certainly it's a very sad day for the Geelong Grammar and broader Geelong community. I have to, regrettably, for the member for Corio, who's still in the chamber, end the congratulations there, because I do want to now turn to the announcement that Labor has made today that it is going to reverse our company tax cuts for any company with a turnover of $10 million and more. And that's fundamentally very disappointing, because as we know, Mr. Deputy Speaker, it was only a few years ago when Labor supported company tax cuts, and the leader of the opposition, no less, is on the record very strongly supporting company tax cuts. And in March 2012, he said, any student of Australian business and economic history since the mid-80s knows that part of Australia's success was derived through the reduction in the company tax rate. He also said, cutting the company income tax rate increases domestic productivity and domestic investment. More capital means higher productivity and economic growth and leads to more jobs and higher wages. Now, that was in August of 2011. And as we know, the Shadow Treasurer has written a book about this very topic, advocating in 2013 that cutting company taxes was a Labor thing. Well, what a shame that we have seen this unprincipled reversal of Labor's position, which, of course, as we know, if Labor was ever to be elected, and let's all keep fingers and toes crossed, Mr. Deputy Speaker, that that never happens for the sake of this nation, we know that that would drive more jobs offshore and drive our nation backwards. And in relation to the member for Corio, I do, and he's a very close friend of the leader of the opposition. They work hand in hand in the same faction. And it's very disappointing that the member for Corio did not counsel the leader of the opposition on this very regressive policy. I believe he's failed in his fundamental duty to put Geelong businesses and workers first. Of course, not only has Labor committed to ripping the Turnbull government's personal income tax cut away from 9 million Australians, Labor has now made a commitment to hit 20,000 businesses employing 1.5 million Australians with a tax sledgehammer. Now, this is really going to hurt many businesses in my region that I proudly represent. Businesses like Cotton On, businesses like Viva Energy, businesses like Air Radiators, and many others who turn over more than $10 million. And what I think Labor has really failed to appreciate, that turnover of $10 million does not represent profit of $10 million. A company with a turnover of $10 million may be making a profit of just a few hundred thousand dollars. So fundamentally, I think Labor has really missed the mark. And just a half an hour ago, I was speaking to some business people in my electorate who work in the surf industry in Torquay, and we were talking about Labor's plan. And it was really, and they all universally said, this is crazy stuff. This is absolutely crazy. Doesn't the Labor Party understand that cutting company tax puts us on a better footing to employ more people, to grow our business and to grow the local economy? So I think last year, of course, the Leader of the Opposition said at a Business Council of Australia function that he was going to declare war on business. I mean, that's a shocking proposition, and that's why the member for Grainler has hit out so strongly on that principle. The Leader of the Opposition has declared war on business, and it's got even worse today. And it's very disappointing that the member for Corio has joined with the Leader of the Opposition in declaring war on so many successful Geelong and Corangamite businesses, which employ hundreds and hundreds of people. And I do condemn the member for Corio for the stance that he has taken, which is incredibly regrettable. We are really, really proud, Mr Deputy Speaker, of our policy to drive down the company tax rate for all companies across this nation to 25%. If we don't do this, we won't be competitive on the global market. And as the Treasurer has said, and the Prime Minister has said today,
I'll just stop you there, Member for Corangamite. Sure. I'll just stop you there. The member is entitled to be heard in silence, so please show due professional respect and courtesy. Please continue.
Thank you very much, Mr Deputy Speaker. So we're incredibly proud of our focus on driving down company tax for all companies across this nation. And yes, there are certainly some issues with many companies. Some companies, including the banks, we know have done the wrong thing. But we have a very strong regime of laws of enforcement, of penalties, of criminal laws in some cases, to hold any company in this nation to account which does the wrong thing. But we should not be using tax policy to do that. And as the Treasurer said in question time today, of course, already we have imposed a bank levy on the banks, which is raising a couple of $1 billion a year, and that's important reform along with the many other reforms that we have made in the banking and financial services sector. And the member opposite referred to penalty rates, and I think it's important to put on the record that the Labor Party, again, in a very unprincipled move, is now trying to unwind the Fair Work Commission, the very industrial relations system it put into place. Thank you, Mr Deputy Speaker. So again, we have seen the Leader of the Opposition, in another unprincipled move, reverse a position that he previously held very strongly. And let me say that perhaps the most alarming decisions that have been made in relation to penalty rates was the infamous Clean Event deal agreed to by the Leader of the Opposition back in 2006, when workers were stripped of their penalty rates in a very grubby deal that the Leader of the Opposition did, driving down... Oh, there's justification for it. Driving down the hourly rate for Clean Event workers without their knowledge from $50 an hour to $18 an hour. And the interjection opposite said that's enterprise bargaining. No, Mr Deputy Speaker, that's not enterprise bargaining. That's wage theft. That is wage theft. And we've seen many other sleazy deals that unions have entered into, particularly the shoppies union, where, for instance, at McDonald's, young people working weekends for 3 years would be $15,000 worse off compared to the award rate. At Big W, they would be some $13,400 worse off, all deals done by the SDA. At Woolworths, they would be over $9,600 worse off.
Order.
And at KFC, they would be over $13,000 worse off compared to the award. So these are some of the sleazy deals that were done between the unions, endorsed by Labor. But of course, as we know, the worst possible deal was done by the Leader of the Opposition himself, hitting some of the most vulnerable workers in our community, who, as I've made very clear, were not informed about what happened to their hourly rate of pay. So, Mr Deputy Speaker, I want to place very strongly on the record my pride in our government, which is standing up for workers, which is driving investment across the economy, which is driving down company tax. There was previous bipartisan agreement on this very important policy for our nation, and Labor has deserted this like they've deserted their own industrial relations system that they set up. And of course, we now know that with the announcement today, another 20,000 businesses will be hit, employing 1.5 million Australians. I condemn Labor, and again, I reiterate my very strong support and pride in our government for driving jobs growth and investment and the growth of this economy. Thank you very much.
Well, I thank the member for Corangamite.